To honor those individuals who protect and serve this great nation, and also those individuals who are adversely affected by war and violence, both here and abroad. We'll follow that with the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning and welcome. Clerk Chapman, would you please take the roll?
Commissioner Harla.
Present.
Commissioner Boyle.
Here.
Commissioner Grimm.
Here.
Commissioner McDonald.
Here.
Commissioner Musaf.
Present.
Commissioner Yugovich. And Chair Commissioner Nelson.
Thank you, Clerk Chapman, for that. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't see any citizens present here. The consent agenda is before us.
So moved.
Moved by Commissioner Harla.
Second.
Supported by Commissioner Yugovich. Any items commissioners care to bring down off the consent? Seeing none, all those in favor signify by the sign aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, same sign. The motion is carried. We don't have any items on our regular agenda. Commissioner reports. Commissioner McDonald, I understand you have a report from out west.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. And again, as the chair stated last week, I was out at the Western Interstate Region Conference, which is an alignment of Western states, which Minnesota year and a half ago, maybe even close to 2 years, put in an application to join that region as it aligns with us in many ways, between the public lands, between PILT, our forests, fire risk, etc. And we were officially accepted into the WIR, which was a little tenuous at times, but I think it's going to bode well for us moving into the future as we have made some strong alliances out there with current NACO president, Mary Jo McGuire. The Western region was the area that put her over the top in her presidency campaign. So they're very well versed on issues in Minnesota, and we've been able to talk to them and explain, especially northeastern Minnesota, what we have here aligns with them as far as, you know, public lands with the Boundary Waters Canoe Area Wilderness, Voyageurs National Park, a number of other public lands, and their big issue is always PILT. And it is also a big issue for us here with PILT. And so when you look at that, that's a very cohesive way to bind with them on the PILT. We also have fire risk, where everybody knows, if you watch any news regarding fire out west, it seems to be a daily occurrence. And now with the smoke we've had here the last few days coming from Canada, but they look for another fire season out there as well. We also had some discussions regarding northeastern Minnesota and all of Minnesota regarding outdoor recreation on public lands, whether it be access, use, etc. So brought them up to speed with that. We also, I know we talked here about search and rescue on public lands a few weeks ago. That is also an area of interest and concern with the Western states, because actually I was seated next to a person from a county in Nevada. 90% of their land in their county is public land. So, you know, we talk about 70%. They're talking 97%. So when you talk also at a very interesting presentation on biomass, where they have a couple of plants moving forward in California and converting pellets, et cetera. And that's something that when the undersecretary of the Department of Agriculture was here up in northeastern Minnesota visiting the Superior National Forest, he talked about an interest in biomass. So there's some discussions going on there. But overall, a very good networking with the Western states. Look forward to working with them. Rich Svay from Lake County is the board member on the WIR. So much along with Lake County, our neighbor, much aligned with where we're at with public lands, forests, et cetera. I think it's a partnership that's going to bode well for St. Louis County and all of northeastern Minnesota as we move forward. And I'd be happy to stand for any questions.
First of all, thank you for doing that. It's that engagement was started many years ago, and it kind of fell apart. It's nice to see it get resurrected, and certainly we do have much in common with a lot of our friends out on the west, southwest, which you would not necessarily think there is, but there certainly is. Any other commissioner reports at this point? Again, we will have an opportunity at the end of the board meeting. Commissioner Grimm.
Yeah, I was, so we had a good day at the Capitol, and then I was at MICA last week, and there were some really positive updates. I know a lot of associations are pushing this, but it's looking really good for the change in MA billing for juvenile mental health. A long time ago when I started this, within the last 3 years when I've been in this job, I had talked to a lot of mental health providers, and I remember hearing from the Wellstone Clinic that they would have juveniles that would come to them, and they would say, hey, sorry, you're under 18, so we can't bill MA. This just doesn't work. There's some real structural issues, and I know MICA and a lot of other organizations have been pushing this, and it looks really positive. So hopefully we'll have some of these structural changes this year where then some of those investments in mental health and those infrastructure costs can be made, and we would know that it would be sustainable. So that was one of the big items there.
Very good. Thank you, Commissioner Grimm. With that, no reason to come back, board, committee, board, nothing there that we have to push through. With that, moved by Commissioner Boyle to adjourn, supported by Commissioner Mousov. All those in favor, signify by the sign aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. The motion is carried. Commissioners, everybody ready to go right into committee of the whole? All right, very good. So I will turn to Clerk Chapman. Please take the roll for committee of the whole.
Commissioner Harla.
Present.
Commissioner Boyle.
Here.
Commissioner Grimm.
Here.
Commissioner McDonald.
Here.
Commissioner Mousov.
Present.
Commissioner Yugovich and Chair Commissioner Nelson.
Here. Commissioners, we have a couple of items on the consent agenda. Someone care to move that? Moved by Commissioner Yugovich, supported by Commissioner Mousov. Anything there of those two items that commissioners want to pull down for further discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor signify by the sign aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. The motion is carried. Next, we'll turn to the regular agenda under Commissioner Harla, the chair of our Finance and Budget Committee. Commissioner Great. Harla.
Thank you, Chair Nelson. The first item on the agenda we'll take out on my agenda is Board Letter 24-213. I'm going to, while I support this, I'm going to move this without recommendation because we have a board meeting, board workshop next week regarding ARPA. So I'm going to make that motion without recommendation.
Support.
Supported by Commissioner Nelson. And this is the School Reengagement Check and Connect Program Transition Funding for ARPA. I'm excited to hear, had a great discussion with Director Mersch, and I know that she's here as well, just to see that we have so many schools that are interested and have seen the benefits of the county's investment in ensuring that students have that check in, the opportunity to have an adult at the school to be checking in with. And so I'm glad that they're bringing this forward. I know that we did vote to support this earlier this year in ARPA, and this is just the continuation to make sure that we have this. So
much discussion to follow.
Much discussion to follow. I think we'll be discussing it a significant amount next week. Director Marsh, is there anything you wanted to say in advance of next week? Administrator Gray, anything, or do we want to have that discussion next week?
Well, I look forward to a more robust discussion next week and at the workshop. And this is to keep us one on a timeline that works for working with the schools and planning more thoughtfully ahead. And two, it addresses the opportunity to have more schools be engaged and impact more kids going forward as we continue with this transition or phasing out plan. But there's some additional costs associated with that, which is, I should rephrase, as additional investments. And we want to talk about that at the workshop. So we're leaving it. We'll have that discussion at the workshop. If you're good. So I think that's where we're at. I've spoken to both the chair and to Chair Harla. Chair Nelson, so I think we'll have a very good news story. We're touching a lot of lives, and that's really significant. And so I think the schools have responded at an even higher rate of wanting to continue their participation, despite the phasing down of the program. I think that's just a good news story that we can talk more about next week.
Thank you. To clarify, the phasing down of the program doesn't mean the pulling back of it. It's the shifting of who's financially responsible for that. So while we're covering a significant portion, it is over the next couple of years phasing from county to school district dollars. And while I can speak confidently as a former school board member that it's not easy to take on additional costs for programming, when something works in a school, they really do that. So I've heard from school board members here in Duluth, but actually regionally as well too, when I ran into a superintendent as well too. So any further discussion? We'll have a lot next week. So okay, seeing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay, passes. Back to you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Chair of Finance and Budget, Commissioner Harla. Under the Central Management Intergovernmental Committee, Commissioner McDonald.
Thank you, Chair Nelson. Before us today, we have Board Letter 24-214, which is the resolution appointing the 2024 Special Board of Appeal and Equalization members and establish their powers, duties, and compensation. I would move that. Is there support? Supported by Commissioner Jugovic. And before we get into this, we do have some new members on this board up for consideration, but I want to say thank you to the people who have served here previously. And not an easy job, not an easy task, but they do their homework and they listen to the concerns of our citizens. And moving forward, I'm glad we have the slate that we do. So with that, Administrator Gray, anything to add?
Only that the initial first meeting will be in Duluth on June 18th at 10 a.m. But more importantly, I want to echo your support, one, for the citizens that continue to step up and those who are new who are being appointed this year, and two, to the assessor's office for their good outreach. And with the support of commissioners, we had some really good, we've got good people here and we've got some continuity. So we're very, very pleased that we have the slate, and they do some heavy lifting on behalf of the county as they hear these challenges and appeals and address issues around valuation classification. So thank you.
Thank you, Administrator Gray. Any comments, questions from commissioners? Commissioner Nelson?
Thank you, Chair, Commissioner McDonald. It is, thank you for that comment, Kevin, about the continuity and some new faces. I am excited to see some new faces on this board, but the continuity between John Vegan and Don Cole, they have about 44 years total between the two of them that they've served on this, and it's tough work. There's nothing easy about this, but they are recognized countywide as two of the very experts on valuation and how to handle these appeals and stuff. But again, I'm excited to see some new names on there, because the truth is, my representative, Don Cole, has asked me for the last 5 years to find somebody else. And I keep telling her, Don, you can't leave until I do. Okay. So she's been on it again. When you've been on that board like that for 20 some years, it it takes its toll after a while. So with that, thank you, Chair Commissioner McDonald.
Thank you, Commissioner Nelson. Any other comments? Hearing or seeing none, all those in favor of the resolution, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? All right, the motion carries. Back to you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Chair Commissioner McDonald. The next one is under Chair Commissioner Grimm under Public Safety and Corrections Committee. Commissioner Grimm.
We have one item, the reallocation of a vacant Information Specialist 3 to Information Specialist 2. I would move that. Is there a second? Seconded by Commissioner Boyle. And before turning this over to administration, it was a reevaluation of a position that will decrease, I believe, 3 pay grades, which is about $4,000 a month, I believe it said.
Annually.
Yeah.
Annually.
Yeah, $400 a month.
$400.
Yep. We're in the same ballpark.
$4 million.
We're talking about
good news.
We're talking about Kevin's pay.
All right, Administrator Gray, do you have any other things to add about this position?
Only that. Thank you, Chair Grimm and Commissioners. Consistent with our policy of approving reallocations up or down that go over 2 pay grades. We do bring that to the board for your awareness, but more to emphasize Chair Grimm's point that our department heads, whether it's public safety or other areas, including health and human services, do scrutinize new positions as they become vacant and make sure it's the right fit with the right skills and the right level. So this has also been reviewed by HR or human resources through their pay equity lens and appropriate evaluation. So the action before the board is to approve a reallocation from an existing Information Specialist 3 position to that of a Information Specialist 2 based on the duties corresponding with that role.
Are there any other questions or comments? Yes, Commissioner Nelson.
Thank you, Chair Commissioner Grimm. As long as we're on the Sheriff's Department here just a little bit, I know our sheriff is doing some reorganization, and quite frankly, I was saddened to lose my supervising deputy, who I've had in our courthouse up there for many, many years, but I'm also very, very encouraged to have a supervising deputy in that role at the jail. And I think that's something that is long overdue. Very much want to encourage the sheriff to continue to look at those opportunities, because I know John Skelton will do a great job down here with the jail, and it's time. And hopefully we can get a better relationship between the jail and NERC, and start utilizing the capacity at NERC to a higher degree. So thank you, Chair Commissioner Grimm.
Thank you. Are there any other commissioner comments or questions? I just want to highlight, I usually do with these positions, I think one of the most important things that we do as a county is when these positions go vacant, we don't just fill them and kind of keep going with the status quo. We really do this reevaluation to make sure that we're as efficient as possible, supporting the team and supporting the mission. So I really appreciate all the work that's done with that. Seeing no other comments or questions, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed, same side. All right, motion passes. Back to you, Chair.
Very good. Thank you, Chair of Public Safety and Corrections Committee, Commissioner Grimm. Commissioners, anything under Commissioner comments? I've got a couple of I voted up here, too. That's a good thing. I don't have a vote going on in my area, but...
No, that was the first comment I was going to make, is we have a very special spring election happening today with ISD 709 levy. So I just want to make sure that Duluth residents are going to get out and vote. Should be very low turnout, so every vote's going to really matter on this one. So that, and I am excited to listen to the chamber's luncheon today with Commissioner Nelson, who's chair of NLX, and Commissioner Harla, who's chair of our depot, talk about NLX to the chamber at lunch and hear what's up and the exciting news. So look forward to that. Thank you.
Very good. Thank you, Commissioner Boyle. And I am also looking forward to that. And I want to publicly thank Commissioner Harla for inviting me down there. As I said, when I was down in St. Paul, sometimes I wonder what this little farm boy from Fayal is doing in some of these settings, but I'll keep pitching as long as they'll keep having me. Commissioner Yugovich.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Just a quick update. I'm aware. I know red meat stuff. So just a quick update. The fair is getting the building from the former Mineview building in Hibbing on the highway as we speak right now. So it's recycling a building that has been sitting vacant for a number of years. And the fair was interested. We got them together with the city of Hibbing, and it worked out really well. So the fair needed an office. The city of Hibbing had a spare building, and now that historic building will be on our historic fairgrounds. So if you get a chance to come take a look, I'm sure we'll have some photos and things. But it is moving from the Hull Rust to the fairgrounds today.
Down the highway.
Down the highway.
Always amazed at how they can pull that off, but they do. I watched them move a brick house one time.
Joey stops moving it with his pickup.
Yeah. I don't know, but I watched them move a brick house one time, and I often wondered, how in the world can you make that happen? But except, Mike, do you want to give a quick comment on the 4-H building up there, too? That's coming along.
They're moving along. I to be honest, I got to get up there and get take a good look at it. Okay. I haven't been there in a little bit, but it is moving along. I get updates. So another wonderful addition to the fairgrounds. It has been something that has been missed for a number of years. We had the conversation a while back about how important it was to get some of these things back in place that were left out when the fair moved. That being the case, we're having groups come in, and it'll be a little more nostalgia along with the modern amenities that we are missing at the fair board and grounds. It'll be the five best days of summer. Probably just got better.
Oh, there you go. Nice. There you go. The exciting part about that for me and I is having a commercial kitchen on site. You know, one of the things we don't realize is that earlier Commissioner McDonald talked about the fire season. Okay, well, folks. In a fire season, if it's out in rural areas, farm animals are involved. People are involved in rural areas, and just a way of a place to bring things. And it's happened before, at least two or three times that I can think of, where we've had to bring a number of animals there to get them out of the path of fires. And to have that commercial kitchen, to be able to serve as an emergency refuge for our citizenry. So that 4-H building is going to serve several functions up there, obviously during the fair, for the young men and women to work it, but just to have it on site in the event of emergencies. It's something that we work with the Ag Society on to make sure that it's available. Anybody else have their hands up here? I was Commissioner McDonald.
Thank you, Chair Nelson. Just an update. People are very pleased in Crane Lake regarding the replacement of the dock. The county dock there was damaged very significantly by the flood. It is, if you get a chance to get up there and take a look at that dock, it is really, really nice. And I've got some pictures sent to me, people using it, etc. So a fine addition to Crane Lake, and thanks to Public Works and our bridge crew and engineer Rachel Gregg as well, putting that whole project together, and got a chance to save some dollars by doing some work over the winter and make that project feasible, and appreciate the work on that. And the people visiting Crane Lake and the local residents are much appreciative of the work they did. On another note, there will be a soft opening of a new restaurant in Ely this weekend in the former Rockwood building. A place called the Frisky Otter will be coming to Ely, much needed as the business is picking up there with the opening of fishing last weekend and now getting close to Memorial Day. So sort of like a Wisconsin Supper Club flavor, But it's going to be a great addition to the Ely community. That's all I have, Mr. Chair.
So we're bringing Wisconsin to Minnesota.
Well, we brought Boyle, so well, we might as well continue.
Gates open. Gates open. All right.
Border crisis.
All right. Any other commissioner comments? Commissioner Yugovich always reminds everybody on safety. Folks, every year I tragically read about or hear or see the accidents that happen within the Boundary Waters. And people that head into the Boundary Waters, it's my caution is this. There are things up there that are very unpredictable. And it is so important to be vigilant when you're visiting that area, because it's not like going to Lake Vermilion. It's a different setting. And again, those tragedies up there, they affect me because I've been going there for so many years and seen so many of them over the years. It's truly, I feel like when they pass out those permits in January, they should require those folks to take a course on some of the issues up there, because that flowing water up there is, and especially in the spring when it's cold. So with that, I'll stop with that. Commissioner Harala.
Excuse me, Chair Commissioner Nelson. I wanted to note there's going to be a lot more activity in the skies this weekend. It's earlier than usual, but this weekend is the Duluth Air Show. So that'll be happening at the airport, but we see a lot of folks going around. So just noting, and I know we've been a long time partner with them. And so I always enjoy, I love going there and visiting our St. Louis County Rescue Squad that usually has a really big presence at it. So I just wanted to make sure that folks knew you'll be hearing a lot more action in the skies.
Very good. Thank you for that. With that, a motion to adjourn is in order. Moved by Commissioner Yugovich, supported by Commissioner McDonald. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Thank you very much for a very good board meeting, folks.